in the next few days here in WCW. He and News with a nice takeover into the wrist lock applied on Davis. Well, fans, I tell you, if you have not seen the incident with Lex Luger and Rick Steiner, then stay tuned because we're going to have that for you in our second hour. It was dynamic, to say the least. And it was shocking. And it's hard to explain exactly what you're going to see in the broadcast. Great drop kick by PN News. Great crowd on hand, as you can see here at center stage. We'll be doing a national television taping here this Monday at 7 o'clock. PN News drops a big, big leg on the arm of Davis. I think when you see the videotape involving Rick Steiner and Lex Luger, that you will agree that when they meet, Rick Steiner is certainly a candidate to walk away with the World's Heavyweight Championship. You'll see what I mean in the second hour. Good belly-to-belly suplex by PN News. And now it may be time to turn up the music and get ready for the Rap Master Splash. On top, he dropped it all on him. Over 400 pounds. Don't forget, everyone, we're going to rap some more.
Yo, baby, yo. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. When the party's over, hear the fat lady sing. PN News is fresh, the rap master sing. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
Fans, when we come back, we'll be joined by Cactus Jack after this time out.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event is scheduled for one fall. Making his way into the ring area from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, at 284 pounds, Cactus Jack. And his opponent already in the ring at 275 pounds from Redmond, Washington, Rick Hardrock.
Rick Hardrock to take on the diabolical Cactus Jack here on WCW. Don't forget, fans, still to come, that exclusive footage of the violent altercation involving the world's champion Lex Luger and Rick Steiner. Cactus Jack still on a vendetta to eliminate Sting from competition here in WCW. But we know that Sting must face ravishing Rick Rude. His new manager, Paul E. Dangerously, will be at ringside at the Clash of Champions live here on TBS on Tuesday, November the 19th. So ravishing Rick Rude, along with Paul E. Dangerously, will have their sights set on Sting's United States Heavyweight Championship at the Clash. But in the meantime, Sting still has to contend with this reckless individual from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico. Cactus Jack wrecking the eyes of his opponent here. Don't forget, everyone, still to come, that big one-on-one matchup, Rick Steiner and Mr. Hughes in this program, plus beautiful Bobby and the Patriots to take on the York Foundation. Lateral press there by Cactus. And he tosses the young man outside. Cactus Jack will take on Heavy Metal Van Hammer at the Clash of Champions. And there he's just assaulting young Rick Hardrock here on TBS. Oh, Big crowd on hand here at Center Stage. And of course, we'll be back here this Monday, 7 o'clock starting time. Hard Rock trying to fight back. Cactus with the kicks to the midsection and a follows it with a forearm. A very reckless, unpredictable athlete. And Hard Rock cutting coming in. Hard Rock trying to snap him over, but Cactus blocked it and comes back with more kicks to the head. Van Sting's going to be in a real tough position, knowing full well that Ravishing Rick Rude wants the United States Heavyweight Championship. Sting must prepare for that match live here on TBS in 10 days. But in the meantime, we know he has a match signed with this man. Kick with the left foot to the face of the youngster. And the double arm DDT, Cactus with a lateral press, and this one is over.
The winner of the match, Cactus Jack.
Cactus Jack has won this event, and he is still hammering away at young Rick Hard Rock. When will we find out who is paying this man and Abdullah the Butcher to make Sting's life miserable? And he's got that trash can back here, hammering Hard Rock with it. Cactus Jack assaulting Hard Rock, and this crowd knows what they want. They want Sting. Hard Rock has just been completely annihilated here by this deranged human being, and we said he takes a lot of chances. Watch this move on the apron, through the air, the elbow right down to the heart. Fans will be back with the WCW magazine in a moment.
Welcome back to TBS. I'm Eric Bischoff with the WCW magazine. Our lead story concerns the recent unscheduled collision between Lex Luger and Rick Steiner. Tony Schiavone was interviewing Steiner when Luger interrupted. Here's what led up to their brawl.
What you need to do is go back to the locker room, talk to your brother about your future conquests, maybe in tag team wrestling, and I'll allow you to walk out of here as friends.
Okay? Yeah, okay, we'll be friends. Hey, I can beat him, I can beat him, and I beat you. Remember in the locker room where me and you wrestled? I beat you.
Tony, what we have here is a little bit of lack of respect. And you're going to get an object lesson in humility right now from the world's heavyweight champion. You're going to learn some respect in the ring.
Wait a minute here. The world champion taking his coat off.
What did he mean? What do you mean by that?
He said a lesson in humility, and Rick, he's going to the ring.
We will have more on this soon, but we won't have to wait long to see them wrestle officially for the WCW World's Heavyweight title. Luger and Steiner will headline the upcoming Clash of Champions broadcast here on TBS Live Tuesday, November 19th. Let's take a look at this outstanding lineup.
World Championship Wrestling presents the Clash of Champions, Tuesday, November 19th, 8:05 Eastern, 7:05 Central, on TBS. In the main event for the WCW World Heavyweight title, the champion Lex Luger defends against Rick Steiner. Scott Steiner will be in his brother's corner. The U.S. Heavyweight Champion Sting faces Ravishing Rick Rude with Paulie Dangerously and Medusa. For the WCW Light Heavyweight title, it's Flying Brian against Johnny B. Badd. World Tag Team title, the Enforcers against the team of the Natural Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham. Heavy Metal Van Hammer goes up against Cactus Jack, a lumberjack match. Top superstars surrounding the ring. Big Josh against Thomas Rich of the York Foundation. stunning Steve Austin defends a world TV belt against the Rapmaster P and Hughes. The Z-Man against the Diamond Stud. Arachna Man against Richard Morton. And Firebreaker Chip of the Patriots takes on Beautiful Bobby. The Clash of Champions, Tuesday, November 19th on TBS.
Just over a week away from the Clash, we asked the Lex Luger camp for their comments.
November 19th, right here on TBS, The Clash. Rick Steiner, Luger agrees with me, and I agree with Luger, that it couldn't happen in a better spot on nationwide television. You saw fit to come out there with your dummy act. And then put it together with enough intelligence to try to insult the world's heavyweight champion. We know and we're convinced that you're not as dumb as you'd like everyone to believe you are, up to a point. But you went beyond that point. You went beyond it when you embarrassed me and the world's champion on national television. Now, buddy, on TBS, November 19th, you pay your dues.
Luger knows he is in for the battle of a lifetime on live primetime television here on TBS Tuesday, November 19th at 8:05 Eastern Time. Cactus Jack made some comments early this week that I think we should hear. This guy is a borderline psychotic, and his comments reflect that of a very dangerous and evil man.
So, Sting, you open box after box, and after it's all over, what did you finally find? You found yourself! You found yourself! You're looking at Cactus Jack. My name is Jack. What's yours? What's yours, Sting? Are you hiding something? Where's your face? It's hiding too. So you open up that box, Sting, and you find yourself. You find yourself finished!
Sting and Van Hammer had better beware of this individual, because Cactus Jack doesn't mind risking his own physical well-being if he can hurt someone else in the process. I'm Eric Bischoff, and that's it for the WCW Magazine, but I do want to remind you that the National Dairy Board wants you to go to Starrcade 91 Battle Bowl, the lethal lottery. Here's how.
In December, when Christmas is over and all the gifts have been opened, there's still one under the tree. The National Dairy Board wants to give you the ultimate gift, a trip for four to Starrcade 91 in Norfolk, December 29th. Airfare and accommodations are yours, as well as ringside seats to WCW Starrcade 91. To enter, send a postcard with your name, address, and phone number to Bill, does a body good, P.O. Box 28955, Atlanta 30358. All entries must be received by December 7th.
Ladies and gentlemen, making his way into the ring area from New York City, at 295 pounds, heavy metal, Van Hammer. And his opponent already in the ring from Seattle, Washington, 240 pounds, John Peterson.
Another tremendous ovation for the heavy metal, Van Hammer. As we mentioned, ladies and gentlemen, Van Hammer will be appearing live here on TBS, 10 days away. That's Tuesday, November the 19th, at the Clash of Champions. He will take on Cactus Jack. On a star-studded lineup at the Clash, you've seen the lineup. A night that Rick Steiner wants to be the heavyweight champion of the world. The enforcers to defend against Barry Windham and Ron Simmons, just to name a few of the great confrontations that you will see, but none perhaps getting more notoriety, more discussion than the man we see in the ring, heavy metal Van Hammer. Caused a problem for me last week. He gave me one t-shirt, and I've got two daughters, so I'm up to... Well, I'm being joined here by Cactus Jack. I don't remember inviting you out here, Cactus.
There was no invitation given. This is simply Cactus Jack's scouting report. See the man in there with the nice boots, the nice hair.
Yeah, Van Hammer.
He's mine on live television, Clash of the Champions. He's mine. So when it's my business to know what's out there, I'm out here. You can like it or you can't like it. It doesn't matter to me, Jim. I'm just doing my job.
Van Hammer, the tremendous Irish whip. What power, for this man. 6 feet five, 295. And Cactus, how does a, how do you, I don't know if I'm having a conversation like with a normal person. How do you combat this kind of strength, this kind of size?
Same way I combated Sting. The same way that Sting is going to be combated and batted about arenas all over the country. All you people out there saying vile things to me, understand one thing. I did Sting a favor. I did Sting a favor. I put the spark back in his eye. Will Van Hammer have what it takes to do or die at the Clash of the Champions? I doubt it. I really doubt it.
Tremendous shoulder block by Heavy Metal Van Hammer. You know, he's got a lot of young fans he calls Hammerheads that are really standing solidly behind this guy.
Well, they can stand beside him. He's got some nice shoes. And sometimes, Jim, when I got nothing else to do, I think about those shoes. How much I'd like to have a pair just like them. But at the Clash of the Champions, I wouldn't want to be in those shoes, Jim. At the Clash of the Champions, I wouldn't want to be in those shoes.
Have you ever had therapy?
Life is therapy. Beating up Sting has been therapy, like a breath of fresh air. And if you think some foot stomping and hand clapping is going to be enough to knock this man down, then Jim, you're the one that needs the advice, not me.
Well, we're only, as you know, 10 days away from that live broadcast here on TBS. And that's one move that you've got to stay away from. That's slingshot suplex. And Heavy Metal Van Hammer remains undefeated.
That's Van Hammer.
All right, Cactus, so what do you think of the, what do you think about this guy? You going to give us any strategy? What's your game plan?
Like I said, nice hair, nice shoes, nice look. When he steps into the ring, the niceness ends.
All right, well, there's Cactus wandering away. Van Hammer with that slingshot suplex. He remains undefeated here in World Championship Wrestling. He will meet Cactus Jack Tuesday, November 19th, live here on TBS. And when we come back, it's the Z-Man in one-on-one competition.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event is scheduled for one fall. Making his way into the ring area at 242 pounds from Minneapolis, Minnesota, here comes Z-Man! And his opponent representing the State Patrol, 230 pounds, Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker.
Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker to challenge the Z-Man here on WCW. And the Z-Man having trouble breaking away from those great fans here at center stage. Z-Man on his way to Chicago tonight. Popular young man, as our good friend Rhubarb Jones let us know from Minneapolis, Minnesota. And he has been training so diligently for his opportunity to wrestle for the World's Heavyweight Championship. He has really, I think, improved his quickness. He's going to wrestle a very quick, smart, offensive-minded match when he gets Luger in the ring. And Sergeant Parker just letting Z-Man know that he's around. Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker, one of the toughest, perhaps one of the most underrated competitors in WCW today. And Z-Man with a... Thought it was going to be a clean break there, but he got a little slap in. Just returning the favor. We saw Z-Man, Dustin Rhodes, and Big Josh in a dynamic six-man tag team event here last Sunday on the main event. And that match has been ordered back for tomorrow's main event, again for the six-man tag team championship. So don't miss that big return match on the main event tomorrow, 6:05, great arm drag takeover by the Z-Man. I really believe that the Z-Man is quicker now than we have seen him in the last several weeks. He is completely healed from that neck injury that he sustained at the hands primarily of the World's Heavyweight Champion, the total package Lex Luger. He is back in magnificent condition. Good takedown. Got him up, had to bring him down. And that's what he hopes to do with the total package, Lex Luger. He wants to Matt wrestle the champion and negate a little bit of Luger's awesome strength advantage that he will have in that contest. And I think it's smart wrestling a quick wrestler like Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker here as well. The more that Z-Man can dictate the pace when he wrestles Luger, the better he's going to, better chances he's going to have in winning the World's Heavyweight Championship. Very explosive. He can beat you in a lot of ways, can the Z-Man. He blocked that move nicely. Got both arms hooked now. Test of strength. He got him down. One, two, and the arm came free at two and a half. But again, he takes him down. That's what he's got to do to Luger. He's got to let him up if he has to, but take him back down as quickly as possible. Still to come, fans, one-on-one. Mike Graham and Johnny B. Bad. They had quite a little altercation here last Saturday, and the promoter's quick to sign that match in a one-on-one situation here. Also, Arachnaman will be with us. I'm going to be talking to Rick Steiner, and we're going to still show you his situation. Explosive situation the wrestling world is talking about on a daily basis with Lex Luger. That's still to come in the program. Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker now showing some offense. And he's taken up. Inverted atomic drop. Certainly would tend to change one's social plans for the evening. Atomic drop again. And Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker now in a very defensive position. Z-Man set him on the top turnbuckle. And drop kicks him right off of him. He is so explosive, and that's something that I'm sure that Lex Luger's going to have to be well aware of as he looks at videotape and prepares to wrestle the Z-Man. Z-Man's great quickness and his agility. Luger has been in recent weeks in some real power match situations. Of course, with Ron Simmons and that epic matchup they had at Halloween Havoc, men like Bill Kazmaier, they're going to come at you with power and strength, but Z-Man's going to be an entirely different athlete. He's going to use quickness and agility. And he's got more experience than does the champion. So it's going to be a very competitive situation when they meet. Nice Irish whip. But he caught him with that karate kick. Came right out of nowhere, and he got it.
The winner of the match, Z-Man!
Fans, when we come back, it's Mike Graham and Johnny B. Badd one-on-one. Wrestling. We're going to take a look at what happened here last week in an incident involving Johnny B. Badd and Mike Graham. Interesting story about this situation in that Mike Graham is the former junior heavyweight champion. Johnny B. Badd has a match signed with the new WCW light heavyweight champion, Flyin' Brian, that match at the Clash of Champions on November the 19th. Now, Johnny B. Badd and Mike Graham will meet one-on-one in a moment, but here's what happened last week. They had a couple of glances over here. They know that you are good friends with Flyin' Brian.
You know, Theodore Long's been around for a while. He knows who I am. He knows my credentials.
Right there, you see the winners. Wait a minute here.
Mr. Russ, I think they're trying to talk to me about something. I think I might go listen to what he's got to say.
All right, Mike, I can understand that, being an athlete, as you are. I don't know what to make of this, actually, but Theodore Long is continuing to debate with Mike Graham, who was nice enough to come out and lend his insight to this last match. Mike now making his way toward the ring. They know full well that Mike Graham perhaps is the best friend right now at WCW that Flying Brian has. It's almost been like a big brother to him. And I don't understand. Well, oh, Johnny B. Badd went for a cheap shot. He just got suplexed right out of his shoes by Mike Graham. And now Theodore Long. Wait a minute, there's a figure four on Long. Peanut Head has the figure four on him from Mike Graham. Johnny B. Badd on the top. Right down on the throat and point of the elbow. Right into the chest of Mike Graham. And now Johnny B. Badd taking his liberties on Graham. And here comes Flying Brian. Johnny B. Badd and Peanut Head leaving the ring. But the damage has been done. That man, Johnny B. Badd, with that assault on Mike Graham, and Graham is hurt.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing in the ring at 217 pounds from Tampa, Florida, Mike Graham. His opponent making his way into the ring area at 237 pounds from Macon, Georgia, coming to the ring by Theodore Arlong as Johnny B. Badd.
Johnny B. Badd, who will challenge Flying Brian for the WCW Light Heavyweight Championship. That one of the great main events that have been signed for the Clash of Champions that we hope you will join us for live here on TBS. Tuesday, November the 19th, 10 days away. But as you saw the videotape, very unprovoked altercation involving Mike Graham and Theodore Arlong and Johnny B. Badd here last week. And obviously the motivation for that is very simplistic. Long and Badd know that Mike Graham is a close personal friend to the Light Heavyweight Champion, been referred as a mentor in certain circles for Flying Brian, and of course, Graham's also a former World's Junior Heavyweight Champion. He made some interesting points here last week talking about the size. Whether it be in the NBA or the National Football League or even here in WCW, a lot is made about size of the athletes. And one thing's for sure, and this is, I think, a good lesson for all the kids out there. You don't have to be the biggest guy on the team to play. Jack Briscoe was a world's champion at 230. Roy Funk Jr. was a world's champion at first time at about 230, 235, and then later at about 245. And Johnny B. Badd, better take this man, Mike Graham, seriously. Because I can assure you that Graham has him in his sights. He has his focus. He has had that focus for 7 days, and he's saying the figure four and your leg's gonna snap, and then you won't be jumping around here and doing all this dancing. Graham's a tough one, I can tell you that. And Johnny B. Badd continues his pre-match festivities here, but soon the festivities will conclude and we will be ready to get it on here. Referee Randy Anderson, the official in this contest. Again, fans, don't forget, we'll be back at Center Stage this coming Monday here in Atlanta on West Peachtree, starting at 7 o'clock, and everyone attending will receive a free WCW gift pack. That's this Monday here at Center Stage, and we're going to start it at 7 o'clock. Well, Graham is a wrestler in the pure sense of the word. He started in elementary school, 5 or 6 years old, when he started amateur wrestling. And he went for a single leg pickup, already working on the leg of Johnny B. Badd. And it's obvious as to the focus of Mike Graham in this contest. It's going to be very hard for him to be knocked out if Johnny B. Badd is in that position for the majority of this contest. Graham is also deceivingly strong, fans. One time a very accomplished power lifter in his weight category. And Johnny B. Badd quickly makes his way to the rope. And referee Anderson calls for the break. Johnny B. Badd has many, many outstanding victories to his credit, but to my knowledge, he has not been in the ring here on television with anyone as experienced and as sound fundamentally as Mike Graham. Another takedown using the leg. Now, great biting the leg, twisting the ankle. Mike Graham has an interesting nickname. I don't know the significance of it. They call him, the wrestlers call him the squeegee man. We'll have to find out more about that. Maybe he just wipes his opponents clean. I don't know the significance of that. But we certainly know the significance of this working on the lower extremity there. And Graham, good move there. Now, a lot of wrestlers would come off the ropes, and if that would have happened, I'm sure he'd have been taken up and over. But Graham held on to the rope. He's very, very ring-wise. Good arm drag takeover. And right back to the leg. Many times you see wrestlers with an arm drag going into then an arm bar. But Graham knows his focus here, and that focus is to work on the leg of Johnny B. Badd, and that's exactly what he's doing. Fans here with a peanut head chant, referring, of course, to that man. The WCW Championship Committee says they have had inquiries from promoters around the world, including Australia and Japan and throughout Canada, regarding the availability of Flying Brian. Fans here saying, break that leg. I don't think Johnny B. Badd has endeared himself to this crowd here at Center Stage very much. Graham's like a professor in the ring. He knows every piece of leverage he needs to use to work on that leg and to lessen the mobility of Johnny B. Badd, and he has been successful there. Graham with the wrist lock. Nice fireman carry takeover. And Johnny B. Badd with a handful of hair. Got him, got Graham back into the head scissor. And referee Randy Anderson didn't get a clear look out of it, but he certainly is questioning Johnny B. Badd here in a Judge Clarence Thomas-like environment. Nice escape there by Graham. And again, Johnny B. Badd pulled the hair. I think he's getting a little frustrated here. We know that Johnny B. Badd is a rookie. And even though he has been in and out of the WCW top 10, and even though he is training very diligently, not only to make weight, but to compete for the WCW Light Heavyweight Championship at the Clash, he has not, as I mentioned, been in there with a master of so many counters and escapes as he is here with Graham. Of course, for our fans down in Florida, Mike's father really attained legendary status in many fronts, not only as a wrestler, but as a promoter, referring to the late Eddie Graham. Good shoulder block by Johnny B. Badd, who weighed in at 237. 20 pounds more than Graham, and again Graham in a move that many say was originated by Buddy Rogers, former world's heavyweight champion, who also resides now down in Florida. That leg grapevine, and then falling back on it, stretching the ligaments. And now Mike trying to set Johnny B. Badd in that figure four, and Badd near the ropes goes for the sanctuary of the ropes, but he's in a bad, bad way here. Johnny B. Badd normally controls the tempo in his matches, and normally he just waits for the opportunity to stick somebody in the face with that left hook, as Theodore Arlong trying to get the circulation back in the leg. And he's going back to what brought him to the dance, so to speak. That's his fist. And Graham just avoided that. Single leg pickup, trying to take him down again. He just took out both points of balance. And that's like the old analogy, using the table legs. You take one of them away, the table's going to fall. In this case, he took them all away. And now Johnny B. Badd ramming Graham's head into the top turnbuckle with a tremendous amount of velocity and raking the eyes blatantly. Perhaps feeling he's got to take a shortcut and he can't out-wrestle Graham. What velocity there. As he just catapulted Graham into the turnbuckle. Now drops the elbow on him. And as quickly as Mike Graham had established offensive superiority, is Johnny B. Badd turning the table. Scoops him up. Remember, still to come, Rick Steiner and Mr. Hughes one-on-one. Plus, beautiful Bobby and the Patriots to take on the York Foundation. Snap suplex. And a lateral press. And Graham able to kick out. I've seen Graham on many, many occasions in an arena, perhaps even in your hometown, getting there early in the afternoon, just a little after lunch, and getting Flying Brian in the ring, and those two guys having some hellacious workouts. And I think that has really accelerated Flying Brian's rise to superstardom. Overhand wrist lock. Johnny B. Badd has his strength advantage, but he didn't use his strength there. He used the hair again. Now the reverse chin lock. And again, if you just joined us, we are going to be showing you in its entirety the volatile situation involving the world's champion Lex Luger and Rick Steiner. That's still to come here today on TBS. And Graham's tossed outside. And Peanut Head Long over there. I'm not real sure how effective those kicks were, but more aggravating perhaps than injurious. Graham makes his way back up to the apron, and he snaps suplex back into the center of the ring. And now Johnny B. Badd has control. That corkscrew elbow caught Graham. He may have him here, and he got two out of it, a good long two. And the rookie from Macon back with another reverse chin lock. Fans, don't forget tonight at 9 o'clock Eastern time, we hope you'll call the wrestling hotline and enjoy the announcers roundtable. All the broadcasters here in WCW will get together and we'll be talking about all the issues of the day in World Championship Wrestling. And we hope that you will be a part of that by calling the wrestling hotline beginning at 9 o'clock Eastern tonight. Until then, I'll have the Ross report. Good belly-to-back suplex. That's a great wrestling counter move by Mike Graham, who has wrestled, quite frankly, a very smart match. Johnny B. Badd now with a slam. He has Graham positioned where he wants him. He's going to take a big chance here. He dropped the elbow, but Graham able to move out of the way. And now let's see if the veteran from Tampa can regain the momentum. Johnny B. Badd rammed into the turnbuckle. Good snapmare takes him over and a knee to the chest. And again, Graham going back to work on the legs, trying to get everything positioned just right for the figure four. And now he's got it. He's got it right now. And look at Long using that metal, that object, whatever it is that Johnny B. Badd uses in his pre-match ceremonies, caught Graham in the back of the head. There's Flying Brian, who saw, I'm sure, what happened on the monitor. The fans here are in full agreement. And here comes senior referee Nick Patrick. I think he wants to restrain Flying Brian. And now Long's getting a chair. The referees are both with Flying Brian. And Johnny B. Badd just got rammed head first. in the chair. Graham's got the chair. The referee sees Graham with the chair. And what's the call going to be? Oh, and he got left hooked. This is rather chaotic here. Now Flying Ryan from behind, oh, viciously, in the back of the head. Johnny B. Badd with that chair, those chair shots, right in the face of Flying Brian. Graham got left hook. And Johnny B. Badd just wore that chair out on Flying Brian, the man he will face at the Clash of Champions. I think Graham has been disqualified. We'll clear that up in a moment.
This event is scheduled for one fall, making his way into the ring area, 235 pounds from Web City, it's Arachnaman! And his opponent from Bethesda, Maryland, at 240 pounds, The Medic.
The Medic and Arachnaman. Fans, I'd like to clarify the official decision in the match involving Mike Graham and Johnny B. Badd. Referee Randy Anderson saw Graham with that chair, and consequently Mike was disqualified for using the chair. So Johnny B. Badd won the match via disqualification. And he certainly will have quite a match on his hands on Tuesday, November the 19th, live here on TBS, when he takes on Flying Brian for the WCW Light Heavyweight Championship.
All right, Arachnaman with a wrist lock on The Medic, who goes to the ropes. We have a clean break. Very colorfully attired Arachnaman, who was successful here last week on WCW. We don't know a great deal about The Medic. In past years, we've known of masked wrestlers being called The Medic. We have no idea if this man is associated in some shape, form, or fashion from those men of yesteryear, so to speak. There you take a look at the man. Side headlock takedown. Good move by Arachnaman. We want to remind you, fans, that WCW returns to the Omni on Thanksgiving night. 8 o'clock's the starting time. Battlestars 91 is being called at the Omni. It's also going to be the Starlight Foundation's Wishing Well night. Starlight Foundation will have Wishing Well set up at all the entrances and at concession stands in the Omni. And we hope to get the fans to donate their spare change that night to try to make sure that the Starlight kids needing wishes in December will get their wish. Hope you'll be involved with us on that very worthwhile project in the Omni on Thanksgiving night. Another side headlock takedown by Arachnaman, who has shown a great deal of quickness and agility in the opportunities that we have seen him wrestle. Fans, coming up in our next segment will be that very controversial footage. Really an explosive situation that erupted recently between the world's heavyweight champion Lex Luger and Rick Steiner. We're going to see that footage, and I'm going to have a conversation with Rick Steiner as well. Both men now to vertical base, and the Medic trying to reverse the pressure in the overhand wrist lock. And it looked as if he used the mask of Arachnaman to take him down. Now working on the wrist with that wrist lock, and again another takedown. And I think that's two times that his mask has been pulled. By the looks of those two rather unsportsmanlike maneuvers, it would seem that the Medic is a relatively experienced athlete. The leapfrog there, and he takes him up and over. Good move by Arachnaman. Arachnaman's back, obviously a little tender. And he reacts very negatively toward that lower back area. Arachnaman certainly looks to have a great deal of elasticity. Collar and elbow tie up. And the wrist lock applied by Arachnaman takes it another turn around. Also still to come in this hour, Rick Steiner one-on-one with a giant Mr. Hughes plus beautiful Bobby and the Patriots to meet the York Foundation. And as we have mentioned, the York Foundation on tomorrow's main event in a big return match for the six-man tag team championship. Good movement in this contest. And Arachnaman drops the headbutt on the medic. Good shot of some of the fans in attendance here at center stage. And we certainly hope you fans will plan on being with us this Monday night at 7 o'clock. We'll return here to center stage for another national television taping. And we fully expect to have Ravishing Rick Rude and Paulie Dangerously with us at center stage on Monday. Irish whip and another leapfrog. He set that time. And a great quickness by Arachnaman to avoid the headbutt by the medic. And the medic may want to return to the operating room here. Referee Nick Patrick will exercise his 10 count to encourage the medic to return to the ring. We've talked about the Omni on Thanksgiving night and returning to center stage this Monday. We also want to say a special hello to the wonderful fans down in Albany, Georgia. WCW will be live in the Albany Civic Center this Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. It's a big, big-time event. A lot of earth-shattering situations have arisen in WCW in just the last few days. The emergence of Paulie Dangerously back in WCW. He's been absent from our broadcast. He was suspended from television due to being too controversial for saying some very derogatory things about various individuals. And during Paul Lee's absence, he was very, very active as he assigned Ravishing Rick Rude to a contract. Paul Lee has also secured the contract of Medusa. And rumor has it he may be adding more to that organization. Irish whip. It goes for a shoulder block. Nobody there. And the Arachnaman really nailed by the medic. Quite a clothesline there. Certainly hope you fans will remember that the wrestling hotline at 9 o'clock tonight will have our second announcers roundtable. Lance Russell, Gordon Sully, Tony Schiavone, and yours truly on that. And of course on the hotline, I'll be updating you on some of the latest developments regarding the Clash of Champions, the Sting Rick Rude situation, the Rick Steiner Lex Luger situation, that and more until 9 tonight on the hotline. And then we'll have the announcers roundtable beginning at 9. The medic dropping the knee into the bicep of Arachnaman, and right now the medic has a distinct advantage offensively on Arachnaman. Arachnaman seems to be at his best when he's flying, when he is in an up-tempo offensive state, and right now he's being grounded, and the medic is controlling the tempo here. Arachnaman, the flat of the foot to the midsection, but his eyes are raked. Very unusual to see two masked men, both very new to WCW, in this in a the same contest. Medic back to the arm bar. Again, he's controlling the tempo, keeping it very deliberate now, and not allowing Aragnaman to move this up to another level. Lex Luger and Rick Steiner have signed that contract for the Clash of Champions. That'll be live here on TBS, as we mentioned, on November 19th, which is a Tuesday night. But we're going to show you what really precipitated that contract signing, and a shocking piece of tape that not only shocked the fans in attendance, but most specifically really startled the world's heavyweight champion, Lex Luger. Referee Nick Patrick calling for the break. Aragnaman trying to get back on the offensive. Irish whip, but he set a little early. He paid for it. Moves like this lead me to believe that this medic is an experienced athlete. He's not made a lot of careless rookie-like mistakes. Aragnaman putting brakes on. Lateral press and a near fall. You fans are in the Atlanta area. Hope you plan on listening to AM 750 WSB tomorrow night for Wrestling with Jim Ross. We'll be taking your calls. It's on the AM dial at 750. It can be heard in many, many states other than here in Georgia. Scoop slam by Aragnaman, who now is getting more offensive-minded. And the pace has certainly quickened here. Nice drop kick, and he just goes up to the top like it was nothing. Headbutt. A flying headbutt right off the top rope. And now Aragnaman has things going his way. The medic is in a jeopardized state. He's got him wrapped up, and Aragnaman's got him.
The winner of the match, Aragnaman!
Fans, when we come back, the Lex Luger, Rick Steiner altercation after this timeout.
Welcome back, everyone, to TBS and World Championship Wrestling. Still to come, that big six-man tag team event we've been talking about, plus the one-on-one confrontation involving Rick Steiner and Mr. Hughes. Now, as we promised, we talked about it here last week, but we didn't have the videotape at our disposal, but we do this week. We're going to take you back in time and show you just exactly how the Rick Steiner-Lex Luger situation got started. Tony Schiavone was talking to Rick Steiner when Lex Luger interrupted, and here's what happened.
He's the champ.
He's the champ. What do you think about you against Lex Luger?
I can beat him.
You can beat Lex Luger?
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah, I can beat him. I beat him before.
You've beaten Lex Luger before?
Yeah, I beat him before.
Well, guess what? I hear his music, and I think...
Where's he at?
I think the world heavyweight champion is just about ready to come out and see us, the fans, and, of course, Rick Steiner. And, yes, here he comes, the world heavyweight champion, Lex Luger. I guess maybe he wants to make some sort of reply to what you had to say.
Now, great, ain't he? He's great.
This man says he has beaten the world heavyweight champion, Lex Luger, fans, and here he comes. Well, Harley Race and Mr. Hughes are here as well.
Harley, dare you come out here and insult the world's champion?
Hold on, Harley. Harley, no need for anger here. I think we can straighten this out.
Hey, Lex.
Hey, how you Rick. Doing? Rick here is just a little bit confused. I think I can put you on the proper path. Now, Rick, you and your brother are a tremendous tag team combination.
Thank you.
You've had a lot of great accomplishments.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're not here talking about beating the world heavyweight champion. You're talking about singles wrestling. That's a whole different ballgame.
I know. You're the best. You're the best. You're the champ.
So what I think you need to do is go back to the locker room, talk to your brother about your future conquests, maybe in tag team wrestling, and allow you to walk out of here as friends.
Okay? Yeah, okay. We'll be friends. Hey. I can beat him, I can beat him, and I beat you. Remember in the locker room where me and you wrestled? I beat you. Tell it.
No, Tony. What we have here is a little bit of lack of respect.
And you're going to get an object lesson in humility right now from the world's heavyweight champion. You're going to learn some respect in the ring.
And a big clothesline. Steiner goes down. And the world champion, right now, in command of this situation. He's going to put the attitude adjustment on. No, he's not. Steiner, a reserve out of nowhere. To the back of the neck. Steiner fights back. Now they're toe-to-toe. The world champion into the corner, reversal, big body drop. Steiner going in and Luger waiting on him. Tremendous move by the champion, sending Steiner to the other side. Nobody home. Over the top. Oh, what power from Steiner! And this impromptu matchup, you're watching here on Worldwide. Mr. Hughes! Harley Race! With the vertical suplex! Belly to belly!
What a dynamic piece of videotape, ladies and gentlemen, we have just witnessed here on World Championship Wrestling. Now, Rick, what this has done, it has thrust you into this World Championship picture at the Clash of Champions on Tuesday night, November the 19th, right here on TBS, live for the world to see. And they'll even be able to see it live in Michigan, I want to tell you that. So you tell your mom
and
dad
to be watching
that one. You were going to wrestle Lex Luger for the world title. Were you surprised that you were able to beat him with a belly-to-belly suplex?
Yeah, because when we was in the locker room, I just put his both arms above his head and made him give, say, Uncle last time. And this time he just walked right in and gave me the belly-to-belly, and I took him.
When you were in high school or in junior high, did you ever have trouble with bullies? Because that seems to me like Lex Luger just tried to come out in that interview and bully you around.
I know. I thought he was going to take me out to the ring and show me some new secret hold, you know, he learns as a champion. No, he goes out and beats up, kicks me like a dog. You don't do that to me.
I know that on Tuesday, November 19th, you're going to have the opportunity of a lifetime. You have built a tremendous reputation here in WCW with your brother as a tag team wrestler. But it seems to me that this has gotten very, very personal. Do you think you can be the world's heavyweight champion on Tuesday, November 19th?
Well, my brother's back, and he's talked to me, and he's seen the match. My brother says he'll keep an eye on Mr. Hughes and watch Harley Race, and all I got to do is take care of Lex Luger. And he said, that's all you have to do. You can do it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, what a championship matchup it will be. The Dogface Gremlin, Lex Luger, for the World's Heavyweight Championship. And when we come back, we'll have six-man tag team action.
Ladies and gentlemen, this event is scheduled for one fall. Making their way into the ring area, accompanied by Ms. Alexandra York, with a combined weight of 694 pounds, Thomas Ricks, Richard Morton, and Paris Taylor, the York Foundation.
And as we mentioned, the York Foundation will be going for the six-man tag team championship that tomorrow here on TBS at 6:05 Eastern Time.
And introducing their opponents, making their way into the ring area with a combined weight of 770 pounds, the team of the Patriots and Bobby Eaton.
Hope you fans will join us for our broadcast tomorrow, 6:05 Eastern Time, the big return matchup. And then tune in to AM 750 WSB tomorrow night at 9 o'clock, and we'll be talking to you about, I'm sure, the volatile piece of videotape that we just saw. Matter of fact, I'm going to try to talk to one of the Steiners tomorrow night on AM 750 WSB at 9 o'clock Eastern Time. I want to tell you something. Rick Steiner, if he sets his mind on being the next heavyweight champion of the world, I want to know Who of you out there will bet against him? He has proven to the world exactly what he can do. And he did it with a belly-to-belly suplex that shook the rafters. Fans here have been very vocal here at Center Stage. And remember, we'll be back here Monday night, 7 o'clock, on West Peachtree. Hope you'll be a part of it. Hope you'll bring your posters and banners Monday night. And the York Foundation will send their man with the most seniority in this organization, Terrence Taylor, in there with Firebreaker Chip. Good shoulder block by Terrence Taylor, taking down Firebreaker Chip. And we know that the York Foundation have been seething over what happened on TBS last Sunday. And they are just a matter of fact when they say that they will be the next six-man champions. And they'll get their chance here on TBS tomorrow. Fireman carry takeovers, of course, by Firebreaker Chip. Now follows it with the arm drags. And a beautiful Bobby in to get involved if the opportunity presents itself. And beautiful Bobby last week. What a physical matchup with Mr. Hughes here on the program as the York Foundation has a little board meeting with the head lady there, Miss Alexandra York. I wonder how she's feeling in recent days after Medusa has made her sentiments known regarding the ladies in WCW. Tag made. Here comes beautiful Bobby. Oh, right hand. Didn't take him long to get that one warmed up. Counter move and a clothesline. And beautiful Bobby, very, very aggressive here. He's a guy that can teach the Patriots a great deal about tag team wrestling because he made it an art form. Todd Champion is a very impressive looking athlete as Ms. York never over just about an arm's length from her erstwhile computer. Taylor now forcing Champion back into the corner. The big Todd Champion hitting anything that's moving and fights his way out of the corner. I know one thing that my fellow announcers will be speaking of tonight at 9 o'clock on the wrestling hotline. That will be this, it just sends shivers up my spine and to see the intensity that Rick Steiner just exploded with. And yes, it was an unofficial match, and no, it was not going to be counted because it was not a match. That goes without saying, but he proved his point. He could be the next world's heavyweight champion. Great shoulder block by Todd Champion on Thomas Rich. We heard last week from the Young Pistols who are preparing to challenge the Patriots for the United States Tag Team title. Beautiful Bobby, very, very popular here at Center Stage. He's from neighboring Alabama. Here in Georgia. Master of the Alabama jam, but what scintillates me is that right hand of his. But even his right hand couldn't put Mr. Hughes down last week for the 1-2-3. And Thomas Rich back into friendly confines of the corner. And here comes Richard Morton. And to say these two guys know each other like a book would be a gross understatement. They have been in the ring more times, I'm sure, than they care to talk about. And that I don't think their rivalry has ever subsided. Irish Whip takes him in. He caught him that time with a clothesline. And a quick tag. Here comes Firebreaker Chip in. Flat of the foot, that's legal. Side headlock. Oh, he's compact and powerful as the Firebreaker. I want to see them wrestle the Young Pistols. That should be most interesting. Two very young teams. And Terrence Taylor, there's a great camera shot. He tripped Firebreaker Chip while the referee was in the far corner on the right side of your screen. And now Terrence with a right hand right to the face. Gut wrench into a power bomb. And the Firebreaker able to get the shoulders up off the canvas before three. Now another quick tag. Here comes Thomas Rich. Quite frankly, last week in that big six-man championship match on the main event, the York Foundation controlled the tempo for the vast majority of the match. Inverted atomic drop. And another tag. Well, the York Foundation showing great teamwork here. And the Firebreaker, with a well-placed kick, comes up with some fists. And a tag to Beautiful Bobby. And Beautiful Bobby hit his neck breaker. Beautiful Bobby with a neck breaker. And now the quiet man from Huntsville, Alabama. He was going up for the Alabama Jam until Richard Morton interrupted and got, I mean, a fist. And he went into the railing. Gosh, there's more action than we could call here. Morton and Rich now dropping Beautiful Bobby over the security railing, chest or throat first. He was going to go for the Alabama Jam, and Richard Morton interrupted that. That gave Terrence Taylor a reprieve. And Morton again off the apron with a right hand. And Bobby sent back into the ring. And he got that shoulder up. Taylor failed to hook the leg that time. And Beautiful Bobby fights back the best way he knows how. And that's those right hands. And Taylor drives his head up into the jaw of Eaton. And quickly tags in Richard Morton. Got to be impressed with the teamwork of the York Foundation. Here today on TBS. Good suplex, lateral press, and Bobby able to kick out. He really wants to make the tag here. And Morton just infuriates Firebreaker Chip. And what that does, look at the referee's position. And what is happening to Bobby Eaton is a travesty here. Morton knew exactly what he was doing because a young, enthusiastic athlete like Firebreaker Chip's going to respond when he's assaulted, and who wouldn't? Great neck breaker by Rich. And Beautiful Bobby maybe just be moments away from losing this one. Lateral press, but he's able to kick out. He's going on instinct now, there's no doubt about that, as Rich secures the reverse chin lock very tightly on the quiet man from Huntsville, Alabama. You never know what's going on in the head of Beautiful Bobby because he just doesn't do a great deal of talking. He's always said he does his talking with his fists, and he does it in the ring. And truer words were never spoken. Bobby made his way back up, but Thomas Rich with a handful of hair, and Firebreaker Chip has got to restrain himself. There's an inside cradle. Bobby's got Terrence Taylor pinned, but you can see the referee was putting a Firebreaker Chip out of the ring. And that time his enthusiasm got the better of it. Bobby really been battered here. He needs to make the tag very, very badly. And his two young teammates should be well rested and ready to compete once they're given the opportunity. Taylor with rights and lefts. Eaton almost out on his feet. Getting very spaghetti legged. And this time it was a counter. He got him in a backbreaker. It took every ounce of adrenaline and strength that beautiful Bobby could muster, but he hit the backbreaker. And now can he hit the tag? That's what he needs to do. Taylor has made his tag. And Thomas Rich making sure that Eaton could not get to his corner and execute a tag. Comes in with more relentless offense. And they're really going for it here. Atlanta Braves lives on all the way up here to November. He's got him again. And this time the referee being detained by the other members of the York Foundation. Man, we've talked about this before on the hotline. Maybe there needs to be two referees in these tag matches. Mike Atkins is an outstanding official. But it's impossible to keep your eyes on six men and one lady. Morton has Eaton in a neck vise, now moves it into a reverse chin lock. Remember, fans, if you just joined us, this is World Championship Wrestling on TBS. And still to come, Rick Steiner and big Mr. Hughes one-on-one. And Eaton again hammered that knee into the midsection. And Terrence Taylor dropped the knee, you saw it. It went right across Eaton's face. And he does it again. Lateral press, and this time firebreaker chip pulled Taylor off of beautiful Bobby, and Thomas Rich choking. Well, the York Foundation takes advantage of every situation. When the referee's back is turned, they make hay while the proverbial sun shines. Beautiful Bobby's body getting whelped. Red contusions coming up over his body where he's been battered here in this six-man tag team event. Taylor went for the neck breaker, but he got hooked. He got hooked and just barely able to get the shoulder up. Obviously, Eaton's lost a lot of strength. And he caught him with the right hand. Taylor went up for a belly-to-back suplex. And beautiful Bobby snuck that right hand in there. Bobby is as close to his corner as he has been in the last several minutes. And he makes the tag to the firebreaker. Firebreaker chip and Terrence Taylor, the legal man. Up and over goes Taylor in a high backdrop. Firebreaker trip, chip rather. He is a trip because his adrenaline is flowing and he's hitting him with every power move he's got. Near fall again. Big roundhouse rights and Terrence Taylor in trouble, but a good counter. Head and shoulder fake. Taylor went down. He's a little lost right now, but I'm sure he'll find himself on the bottom end of this and more. No, that was Rich that stopped the count. What right hands by beautiful Bobby. He's nailing anything that moves. And now they raked his eyes. Beautiful Bobby's eyes have been raked. He's temporarily blinded. And he tattooed the firebreaker. He must have thought it was one of the York Foundation. And Morton's on top. And the York Foundation wins it.
The winners of the event, the York Foundation.
Well, beautiful Bobby was raked in the eyes. And was Taylor congratulating him for his help? I think it was inadvertent. Boom, what a right hand. Taylor goes down. Todd Champion trying to console beautiful Bobby, who was temporarily blinded there. And he did indeed dim the running lights of the firebreaker. Taylor is out of it. Man, he took a right hand right to the jaw. I wonder how that will affect tomorrow's big return on the main event. We're going to take a look here. He had gotten nailed. Morton fell right on top of him. But it was the right hand from beautiful Bobby that put the firebreaker down. Fans, when we come back, what happened?
Action, Rick Steiner, Mr. Hughes, they're next.
Accompanied by mentor Harley Race from Kansas City, 365 pounds, the bodyguard, Mr. Hughes.
Ladies and gentlemen, while the referee gives these two awesome athletes their instructions, we'll take a quick timeout, and we'll be back with this one-on-one confrontation on TBS right after this. And we are back here, ladies and gentlemen, on TBS. The bell has just sounded. Harley Race, the advisor, talking to the referee and trying to psych out the dog-faced grim and Rick Steiner, but there's no psyching out this athlete. What a dynamic piece of videotape we saw earlier here involving that huge man, the bodyguard of the world's heavyweight champion, Lex Luger. Harley Race and Rick Steiner. And the focus on this will be for that huge individual, Mr. Hughes, at 360 pounds to take Rick Steiner out. It is quite obvious. After the videotape we saw, that on a given day, on a level playing field, if you will, that Rick Steiner could certainly be the next heavyweight champion of the world. We know that Steiner and Luger will meet live here on TBS at the Clash of Champions. That's just 10 days away, Tuesday, November the 19th. But in order for Rick Steiner to make it to the Clash of Champions here on TBS, he needs to be at 100%. He needs to be healthy, in other words. And I'm sure that's exactly what Luger and Race have advised Hughes, is to bust him up. Hurt this guy. Harley Race, a 7-time heavyweight champion with a wealth of knowledge, but his ethics certainly have been in question. And there's a vicious right hook right to the ribs, and now one to the head. Rick Steiner giving away almost 100 pounds in this contest. There's a headbutt, and I don't think that's going to faze the dog face one. Irish whip takes him in, and at 360, planting himself on Steiner here. Another Irish whip. He's trying to block that hip lock, and he successfully did that. But Steiner's going to take him right back up. Hughes rakes the eyes here. And now scoops up the dog-faced criminal and slams him. Got some momentum, but missed the elbow. Steiner with a kick to the solar plexus, follows it with the right hand. Trying to get him over again. This is tall. Man, he got clothesline right out of his boots there. What an awesome athlete is Mr. Hughes. An outstanding defensive tackle in the Big 8 Conference at Kansas State. He has been a very imposing bodyguard. But I think in the upcoming weeks, we can expect to see more of Mr. Hughes in the squared circle. We saw him last week in that dynamic matchup with beautiful body. About a half a count too early. And you can tell that the tutoring of Harley Race is really having a positive effect on the in-ring tactics of Mr. Hughes.
who is not wearing regulation wrestling boots as he kicks Rick Steiner outside. And now Race with that left hand hit him right in the face. The referee's back was turned, and you can bet that any time senior referee Nick Patrick turns his back on Race, Race will take advantage if he can. Hard-hitting matchup thus far here on TBS. And Hughes now rammed rib first into the steel barricade. Race now backing away wisely, distancing himself from Rick Steiner. Remember, fans, tomorrow the WCW six-man tag team championship will be decided when Dustin Rhodes, Z-Man, and Big Josh take on the York Foundation. That at 6:05 Eastern Time tomorrow here on TBS. Good snap mare by Rick Steiner. And Steiner, who was an undersized heavyweight at Michigan, giving away 100 pounds here. And that was a very unique but effective counter by Mr. Hughes. Notice those boots that Hughes is wearing. To my knowledge, they are not regulation wrestling boots. More like a street shoe, but something you'd find in a street fight environment. That's an everyday occurrence for Hughes. Big bear hug now. I don't know how strong this guy is, but at 360, he's got to be tremendously powerful. The tattoo on that right shoulder signifying the dog-faced gremlin. That's one way out of it. And right back into the bear hug. Well, there's no doubt that after the explosive situation that took place between the world's champion Luger and Rick Steiner, that when this match was signed, you can bet that Race and Luger spent a lot of time with Mr. Hughes preparing this game plan. I'm not so sure that, as I mentioned earlier, if they're looking for a W, they're looking to hurt this man, but they're not going to do it by hitting him in the head. He rakes the eyes, comes back with a vicious right hand. Steiner, a lot like perhaps the WCW version of the legendary Rocky Marciano. He leads with his face. He takes your best shots, but you better be prepared to take his. Oh, what a Steiner line. What explosion. What power from Rick Steiner, who now is not thinking about tag team wrestling. He's thinking about being the heavyweight champion of the world. Right hands, and Hughes in the most trouble he's been in a contest. What elevation. And remember, this big man is 360 pounds. Another right. And he went right back to the basic bear hug. Basic yet very, very effective. Steiner normally dominates his opponents with high impact moves. We saw what he could do with a move like the belly-to-belly suplex. We saw that earlier in this broadcast against the best in the world, the world's champion. But right now, the dog-faced gremlin is being sternly challenged by Mr. Hughes. Hughes plants that 360 again on Steiner. Quite frankly, Hughes is controlling the action here. And again, Steiner tossed outside, and the referee's back is turned in Race with a vicious kick to the ribs. Race, a genuine legend in his own time, seven times holding the World's Heavyweight Championship. But over those years, he was always known as a very, very strategic athlete. He knows every trick. He knows how to prepare for any match. And now perhaps he's living vicariously through Mr. Hughes in this particular contest. Steiner's ribs have got to be a sore spot. No pun intended, but a problem for him after being kicked by a race. Of course, those bear hugs squeezing him. And he's going to go for it again. Steiner got him, and he got him up. This man, one-on-one for the World's Heavyweight Championship. He wants to sniff out that challenge right now. And there's Scott Steiner. Scott Steiner back here. Scott Steiner coming to the aid of his brother. Oh, what a confrontation it will be for WCW's richest prize. Rick Steiner and Lex Luger for the world title. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to go back and take another look right here. What a Steiner line. High impact move. And then after pinning Hughes with that belly to belly, just like he did Luger on the videotape earlier in the program, he nailed Harley Race. What a situation, fans. We'll see you tomorrow on the main event. So long, everybody.